Hello and welcome to the Dclient, the mud client created exclusively for the game Alter Aeon. This video will demonstrate some of the general features of the program. I'm your humble narrator, Shadowfax, longtime staff member of Alter Aeon. I would like to first direct your attention to the large section in the center here. This is the main output window, where most of the action is. You see that I'm not currently connected to the game. Below is the input window, where you type commands into the game. You'll see some buttons here on the right-hand side. These are the hint buttons. Right now the buttons are encouraging me to either log in or quit. The buttons change to accommodate the current actions that your player may find available at any given room, such as opening a door or picking a lock. This is the default configuration. You can change the layout here in the Preferences menu. You'll notice a number of other options available, such as the status bar and sky bar, which would be displayed above the input window. Notice here the Show Color Flash Events option. This has the screen flash to alert your attention to significant events. For example, your screen will flash red if your character is inflicted with heavy damage. You can turn on function buttons to represent the function keys on your keyboard, in case you find it easier to click on them instead of touching the keys. You can also bring up some direction buttons to click on and move your character around. Or, you can use the number pad to do it. See how the direction commands are automatically entered as I use the number pad. By default, Local Echo is enabled to display your entered commands, and those commands are separated by lines like you see here. You can turn this option on or off using the Preferences menu. You'll also notice that there is a scroll bar on the output window, which you can toggle off if you wish. Let's move over to the Themes menu. You can change the color of pretty much everything in the Dclient. Buttons, background. You can change the background pattern if you wish. You can change the font colors to emulate the color on other popular clients, such as ZMUD or GMUD. With the Change Font option here, you can change the window fonts to anything you want or the buttons. Courier New is the default font. Let's try another popular Windows font, Times New Roman, and see how that looks. There isn't much we can do with Windows or the map while offline, so let's scoot past them. Online info will open the appropriate page in your web browser about any of these topics, like quests or spells and skills. Let's check out the About option here in the Help menu. You'll see that I have version 1.094 of the Dclient running. Back here, you can get a list of keyboard shortcuts to help you navigate the Dclient quickly. You can page up or down through the scroll back. Note that when you do this, the outline around the output window changes color. This indicates that the screen scrolling is locked, so it won't move around and you can read it easier. You can also lock the screen by manipulating the scroll bar or pressing Ctrl S or Ctrl Z. You can unlock the screen by pressing Ctrl Q or typing anything into the input window. You'll see more keyboard controls listed for turning the map on and off, making the screen font larger or smaller, manipulating the map size, or the size of the input window. And that should do it for now. Don't forget to visit the website, and happy mudding.